So let's see together in this lesson, à cause de, and it's quite useful. Let's see exactly how does à cause de means for starters, and it means because of. And we'll see in this first part how to construct it when we combine it with a pronoun. So, classic sentence, c'est à cause de toi. It's because of you. C'est à cause de lui. It's because of him. So we can see that now we've got this à cause de, and then you can see that quite clearly you will have a pronoun after, like in English, you, in French it will be toi, him, in French it will be lui. So let's see the pronouns that we'll have to use, and they are called the pronouns, les pronoms toniques, moi, toi, lui, elle. So remember, we'll make the difference between the masculine, lui, and elle for the feminine. After that plural, nous, vous, eux, elles. D'accord? So moi, toi, lui masculin, elle féminin, nous, vous, eux masculin, elle féminin. À cause de lui, nous n'avons pas pu partir. Because of him, we couldn't leave. Si nous ne pouvons pas sortir ce soir, c'est à cause d'eux. If we can't go out tonight, it's because of them. So I just wanted to show you that, well, if you want, you can start with it, à cause de lui. Hein? Or then you can end with it, c'est à cause d'eux. So it's quite flexible. Remember to structure the sentence according to the position of this à cause de. But in these situations, remember that they are connected with pronouns, à cause de lui, à cause de, okay? À cause d'elle, je n'ai pas pu prendre mon bus. Because of her, I couldn't take my bus. La famille entière ne pouvait se déplacer à cause de lui. The whole family couldn't move because of him. Okay, so same thing here. I wanted to put it first and then last, so you can see how it works. À cause de moi, à cause de toi, à cause de lui, à cause d'elle, à cause de nous, à cause de vous, à cause de, à cause d'elle. Okay, so you can see that quite clearly for à cause d'elle, so the singular one, you will have to drop your e and put the apostrophe. It will be exactly the same thing for the plural form, à cause de, à cause d'elle, e will have to disappear and you will put l'apostrophe. And it's also possible to use à cause de with a noun. So let's see how it goes. C'est à cause de Paul. It's because of Paul. C'est à cause de mon frère. It's because of my brother. À cause de ton travail, nous n'avons pas pu partir. Because of your work, we couldn't leave. Si nous ne pouvons pas sortir ce soir, c'est à cause de mes parents. If we can't go out tonight, it's because of my parents. À cause du nombre de passagers, je n'ai pas pu prendre le bus. Because of the number of passengers, I couldn't take the bus. Les gens ne pouvaient pas manger à leur faim à cause de la guerre. People could not have enough to eat because of the war. So as you can see, when you put a noun, I mean, it can be the name of somebody, it can be just a noun with the article, it can be with an adjective, possessive, demonstrative, it can be also the partitive. So remember that everything is possible, you just need to be careful about the logic in your sentence. And I think this is it. Voilà beaucoup. Merci pour votre attention.